It's June 30th, 2015, 6:32 a.m. Just come out the first thing this morning. Oh, I'm not awake yet, good, but man, I need to start getting up another hour earlier than this. Go to bed at 10 o'clock and get up at 5:30. Oh. Man, I'm having problems with these hookworms. Got three off yesterday. They're inside that. You know, the tomato plants look okay. This one here, just they got back on this one. You can see how the leaves are starting to be. We're eating off. There's a tomato on it. Right there, you see that green tomato, little tomato. Got coffee grounds all around them now. Got the hookworms off too. Oh man. I got one off of my other tomato plants, the one that we had grown inside yesterday too. I searched over all these good yesterday and then came out here last night about 9:30, 10 o'clock and checked over every part of this plant. Hookworm. They're in there, like I said. They grow a thick green caterpillar floating around in some chlorinated water. Three of the four squash are growing. This is like buttercup squash. What is it right there? I don't know which one that one is. This one here either. That should be buttercup squash. There's nothing growing yet. I soaked it. Giant bean. Nothing's growing yet. That scarlet bean, whatever it is. Jackson Wonder beans, about 8 inches tall over there. That's about 5 inches, four inches right there. See, I made myself a little thing here. A little trellis. I'm not gonna go out in the garden because I don't have a basket. Lucy, come here! Lucille! I feel mosquitoes on my ankles. Oh. See, you can see the purple hulled peas? That's why I call them purple hulled peas. See this one right here? It's already changed now. This is the last day of June and it's already changing. So that means we'll have a lot of purple hulled peas this year. There's a few of them that's changed right there. There's four stations of purple hull peas, and there's two or three plants in each station. But you can see the amount of purple hull pea pods. This is the first one right here in this row with that one right there. I can see that from the house. And then these other three. And then these are all black-eyed peas. Doing really, 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 really good. Zucchini's doing okay. I treated this yesterday with baking soda and water. And see the new leaf growth? Because they'll get really cruddy looking, and then they'll come back with new leaves and all this. So my honeydew melons, or if you want to call them cantaloupe, right there's one. Thought my wife said there's another one. There is inside there. You can barely see that green one right there. It looked like a regular cantaloupe. These are gonna be good. We got five of those, or four of those sweet baby little round bowling ball ones, I call them. We got five of those long watermelons too. I'm not gonna walk out there right now without my cane. I can't really see right there. See how they're out there. Two right there, I think. Anyway, I need a bucket for the okra. There's some more cucumbers. We took some to a church yesterday. Cucumbers, next year we learn better. We get a lot of cucumbers. There's probably 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 6 or 7 cucumber plants here. This is a straight 8. We got one off yesterday. It's growing out into the yard here, the walkway. The straight 8 is about the second one from the end down there. And I don't recall the other heirloom name for these others. But there's cucumbers all over underneath there. Lots of bread and butter pickles, lots of dill pickles. Purple pole beans doing so-so. They're doing okay. Sometimes it seemed like they were starting to die out, but no, they're coming back. I sprayed them yesterday. Okra, we've already got us about 50 okra pods. Every day, basically, you pick them off. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. You see that one right there? It's a small one. It's a burgundy okra. We got green okra and a burgundy okra. The green okra is either a spineless or just they call it green pod okra. You can barely see that one really, right there. So that's not ready to be picked. Later on today though, it will be picked, probably this evening. You see some down in here. See, as the flowers coming off of them. That's about 5 inches. There's a couple on here like that too. You see green at the bottom and then you'll see a flower coming off of it. These things put out plant after plant after plant. I mean, not plant, pod after pod. Pick them once or twice a day. They're just now starting to produce. You know, you're picking them. We've been picking them twice a day, but you know, just getting a handful each time. But you know, like I say, you see right there. That's the first one I think I showed. That's about 4 inches long. Where is that now? See the green on it too. They're usually all burgundy. Green pod will be green. Burgundy is the deep red burgundy color. But you see all kinds of pods. Oh, I see one in there. Gosh, there's, you know, long ones inside here. Rather than just picking them right away, we'll wait maybe. We'll wait until maybe 11 o'clock or so to come out here and pick. If not, we'll wait until this evening around 7 o'clock. It's starting to cool down a little bit. It's supposed to get up to about 89 today. We'll come out here around 7 o'clock and pick all some of these okra. Well, actually, we'll do our little one thing. We'll go through the whole garden, get the cucumbers, any purple pole beans, and okra, and cucumber, and maybe some more zucchini. I love zucchini. After a while, you kind of get a little tired, like, oh, more zucchini, oh yeah. But like I said, it's good. And these are our torch sunflowers here. Okay, that one right there is a tall. That's torch sunflower. That's probably about 6 foot, maybe 6.5 feet tall. The flower's just coming out on the top of it. You know, this is a Titan sunflower. This one here, there's no yellow. Yeah, this will have a big yellow flower. You see a few of them out here. You're seeing the far end. I can't see this viewfinder again. Let me get over this way. Got sun over on my right. What is that right there? Traditional yellow sunflower. Right there. Facing the sun as it comes up. There. So you see the whole 3/4 wall I made over there of sunflowers. These torch ones are prettier. I'm going to make these like about 70% on this end, on this garden, 70% on that number 3 garden in the back. There's nothing on that one now. And then I'll probably put about 40% on the back with the rest of them being torch. I mean Titan, the tall ones. And I got Titan along the front there in two sections. So, 6:30, gosh. Man, I can remember, usually I get about 5:30 and ready for doing everything. Now my big thing is I'm so tired. Being outside in this fresh air, it's not fresh. It's not really air, I don't think. Doing a number on me because I want to sleep all the time. See, this purple pole bean has come and almost died off three times. I spray, like I say, water and baking soda to get off any fungus, and it seems to come back again. With it being June, it's been out here for over a month. Maybe even as much as 6 weeks. But this one too, it wants to, you see the yellowing leaves on it. That's what they'll look like. They'll look like those pumpkin leaves with the brown on it. That was the first thing over there, the zucchini, and I sprayed it with the baking soda and water mix. And then, like I said, you see like how this one looks. It's like a new plant almost because it's new growth coming after you spray it. Well, tomatoes are delicate. The main thing we're having with is the hookworms. And like I said, if I see another one, I'll try to make sure I get it on video. But the four that came from Kmart look like they're too thickly. You know, they I don't know what they do to make them grow like this in a hot house, I guess. But look at ours right here. They're a little bit lighter green. They look healthier than the dark green. And this one, like I said, just this one had a hookworm on it. I got that one off. And this is bigger than this one. Actually, the second one is bigger than the four we bought at Kmart. And those were probably greenhouse grown. These are supposed to be beefsteak heirloom tomatoes. This one, I don't know, I don't recall, because like I said, I got so many different types of seeds. I have at least around 12 different tomato plant type seeds. Oh, I got a bee going on the flower over there. You can see it in the, oh, there's a crack in the viewfinder right where the bee's at. Anyway, let that bee get on there and pollinate them flowers, because I got a small tomato on one or two of them. The one that does almost all the leaves are eat off. I got two small tomato plants on, two small tomatoes on them. Right there, I think, yeah, see them? I got little bees and gnats on me, so it's hard for me to hold this thing steady. Doing better than I usually do. Usually I'm really just shaking all over the place and moving the camera real fast. But that's the condition of the gardens on June 30th, 2015, about 6:40 a.m. right now. Yeah. Guys need to grow some kind of food, some peppers, some tomatoes. It's my biggest, the easiest ones to grow generally are tomatoes and peppers. You just got to watch for hookworms on those tomatoes, though. And peppers, like I say, there's two in this row here. There's pepper, and the one in the back there is a pepper. I got three peppers along the front of the garden over there on the border. And then over here by the house. This is the primary pepper bed. 19 pepper plants out here. And all about 15 of them are doing extremely good. You gotta get in there and get the grass up around the house there pulled out. But I just staked all of these except for two or three with smaller stuff. Four of them with smaller. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six with small stakes. The rest of them got 4 foot stakes. So again, it's getting to the point where it's beyond planting anything. If you can get anything from seed, it'd be real hard unless it's a fall type of vegetable. I don't know. I don't know the different types, which is fall. Like broccoli, maybe I might put some broccoli in another two or three weeks in 5 gallon buckets, put two plants in each one. But we got beans, tomatoes, peppers, peas, another pea, zucchini, cucumber, okra right now, and pumpkin. Sorry, I'm getting mosquitoes on me. I'm gonna go in the house. So that's the garden.